What's up, YouTube? It's Barrymore with another DHC video. Now, a lot of people have been asking me how I build my Garai and why do I use him. So let's take a look at his skills real quick. On his basic attack, Ren, every fourth attack, he does damage based on defense. So he does scale off of defense. On his first skill, Cryptic Barrier, he gives everybody around him and himself immunity, which you guys already know, immunity is amazing because you don't want, if you're fighting dragons, you don't want him to have, you don't want the left tower to put a lower defense on you. If you're fighting Widow, you don't want any ongoing damage dots to be put on you as well. Second skill, Searing Breath, lowers defense in a frontal cone. So anybody he hits that's in his way, pretty much in a frontal cone, he'll lower their defense. Obviously with an accuracy check, but he does lower the defense on the dragon. He'll lower defense on the Widow, which means more DPS and faster clear times. On his third skill, Frightening Gaze, he does another frontal cone attack. It's a lot wider than his second skill, but he does disorient everybody that he hits, again with the accuracy check. Disorient is also great because you do get the boss does reduce damage on a fixed chance, and he also cannot crit you, which means the boss on Elder Dragon or Steel Widow. Now, another great thing about him is his synergy trait. He does have a 30% defense boost to all your units. So if you're doing Elder Dragon and you don't have 700 defense on all your on your allies and you need that boost, then Garai can do that for you. He'll give you more survivability, which means more defense, less one shots, and more survival all over, overall. Widow doesn't really matter because she penetrates through defense, so his leader skill is kind of void in there. But he is a water type, which makes him exceptional for Steel Widow 10 because you are fighting a fire type Widow. So his skill is actually not bad, guys. His skills all his skills are really good. Lower defense, disorient, and immunity. Everything good for any kind of PvE progression. Now let's take a look at his gear. I have him vital, sturdy, and precise. Vital because he's only a 5-star, so he doesn't have that much HP. His pool is about, 14,656. So I give him a little bit more health. Sturdy because he scales off of defense. And precise because I want him to land his debuffs every single time that he can, or as much as he can. And as far as his shoulders, bracers, and gloves, I have him on the defense, HP. Now, defense, obviously, again, because he scales off of defense. So mine is over a little bit over 1500 defense, which is awesome. He doesn't get one shot. Even if he gets defense broken, he still has a lot more defense so he can survive at least a big attack. Now the HP, I have him because I said he does have a small HP pool at a 5-star level 50. So I give him HP for a little bit more survivability. So mine is sitting at about a little bit less than 35,000, about 34,000 and something. And 49% accuracy, and like I said, 1500 defense. So my Garai, really, really good for Elder Dragons, guys. I don't use him in Widow. I can if I wanted to, but I have a different team for that. Excuse me. But for Dragons, he is my leader, pretty much. He's in the front line, and he has his leader ability because I do like the survivability. It makes my runs go a little bit smoother. I know most of you guys run Rota's nature reduced cooldown on it, but I personally run my Garai's for my team because, like I said, more survivability. Once I get him 6-star, though, I will be replacing this with a defense person because his HP pool will be a little bit higher. So he should be doing good. He'll be doing good on just having this on on defense for more defense on his scaling abilities or skills. Now, the reason I replace him, or I replaced Zircon with him, was because while Zircon does have nice heals and he does also have immunity, I felt that it was that Zircon's AI, and I'm sure a lot of you guys can agree with me, it's not as good as I want it to be. Because what you want from Zircon, yes, you want the heals, but you want him to have to cast immunity like right away as soon as it's up, right? But he doesn't. So with Garai, he immediately as Cryptic Barrier is up off of cooldown, he'll immediately cast it. Now the range on immunity is the same as Zircon, so it's not getting any bigger or any smaller. So the bad thing is, you know, if you guys are off to the side, to the right, doing their own thing, they're not going to get immunity. But as long as they're right by him or anybody that is around him, they're going to get immunity. They're going to have more survivability. They're not going to get defense broken. They're not going to get ongoing damage. So he does offer the same thing that that Zircon offers in, as far as immunity, except he does it better because of the fact that you want him to cast immunity immediately so he doesn't, so you don't get any debuffs on your units. Mine needs two more skill ups, so as soon as he gets those two more skill ups, his immunity timers will be up a lot more often. Right now it's about, I think, I want to say like 2 to 3 seconds time where he, like a timer where he doesn't have immunity up. So there is that RNG factor, guys, when you're doing dragon, and you might get armor broken because of the that little time window. But once he gets those two more skill ups, I believe it'll be like maybe 1 second or maybe even a full uptime, if you have like a Xenia lowering cooldowns or if you have a Manas lowering cooldowns as well. But for now, guys, he does work. He works on my other dragon team. I love this guy. He also works on my arena defense, on my arena offense. And the reason I say arena, because as soon as your fight starts, he casts his immunity, so you can go in there and do whatever you need to do, and he'll obviously keep casting it as the battle goes, on top of his defense break and his disorient. So not only is the Garai the only good one, there are also other ones. The Light Basket, I believe it's probably, if I had him, I'd probably replace Garai with him because of he has the same abilities as Garai, except he has a stun. I would replace him in my arena defense and offense because he has a stun, and stuns are really, really awesome in arena, especially in defense, because you want to stall up to that 1 minute, or you want to help DPS your enemies faster by not letting them attack. But overall, guys, I think most of the baskets are really good. They're definitely, I see them a lot in arenas, and like I said, people have been asking me how I build mine and why I use him, and this is why, guys. I personally love my Garai, but if unfortunately, when you ascend him, he doesn't ascend into any extra stats or anything, because he doesn't have accuracy. He doesn't ascend into accuracy or create a rate of resistance or anything. He just pretty much gets a boost of stats, because he already has his leader ability with ascended or not. But anyways, guys, if you have any questions or comments on why I still use him, or if you want to talk more about him, let me know in the comment section below. If you like the video, go ahead and leave a like, and I'll see you guys on the next video.